This year, there are three new iPhones to choose from. But is there any reason to get the smallest and least exciting option? At £699, it's more expensive than previously, but the iPhone 8 is the cheapest phone from Apple this year, and hardly the priciest phone on the market either. The initial issue here is that the new iPhone doesn't really look any different. Apple has essentially stuck with the same design for 3 years now. A return to a glass rear cover is the main change to be aware of, which actually makes it more grippy in the hand, but slidey when you put it down. It's actually a bit heavier than the iPhone 7, but we like the balance. The reason for the glass back is so the iPhone can finally have wireless charging. It's a handy feature, but nothing new in the wider market, and not enough on its own to tempt most users to upgrade. Other design elements stay the same, so there's a static home button, no headphone jack, and the device is IP67 waterproof. Apple seems to like its two phone size formula, so the iPhone 8 remains at 4.7 inches with dated chunky bezels. It does get True Tone technology to automatically adjust the colour temperature of the display, but it's the Super Retina display on the iPhone 10 that's interesting this year. Inside the iPhone 8 is a ridiculously fast A11 Bionic processor that puts up benchmark numbers similar to some high-end laptops. That's all well and good, but you won't notice that raw speed in day-to-day life. A much more tangible upgrade is getting 64GB of storage as standard, matching many Android rivals. That's double the iPhone 7, and you can jump to 256 if you wish. The camera is slightly improved, and we're particularly impressed with low light performance. The main tweaks come in the video department though, as you can now shoot 4K at 60 frames per second, and slow-mo video now at 1080p and 240 frames per second. Of course, you get iOS 11, which brings some new tweaks, namely to the notifications and control center, but older iPhones get the new software anyway. Realistically, the iPhone 8 is a 7S with the wrong number on the box. It's still a solid smartphone, but that's no longer enough in the age of bezel-free handsets. Wireless charging is the biggest change here, so you'll need to be on a fairly old iPhone to justify the upgrade. Our eyes are firmly set on the iPhone X.